Hi everyone. So today we are going to be fermenting cucumbers. Now, most of you guys will know them as pickles, right? We're going to be pickling, which is like another word for fermenting cucumbers. And I made some, I have a jar right here, of some I made on the 20th. So just 4 days ago, and I just ate three. They're absolutely delicious. They're still a little salty, so I'm going to let them ferment for maybe 2 days, and then I think I'm just gonna put them in the fridge and enjoy them. But fermenting, to kind of reiterate or to repeat myself from the last video, few videos of fermenting, is so incredible for your body, so incredible for your gut bacteria, right? Your gut bacteria are what's going to be keeping you healthy. And what better way than to eat it through delicious foods, to keep you healthy through delicious foods. So I have two medium size, actually they're kind of large, but we're going to go with medium size cucumbers. And I get all of my food from the farmer's market. So The cucumbers aren't gonna have a waxy coat on them. These are just straight from the ground, right? And they wash them off. If you're buying your cucumbers from the supermarket, from the grocery store, you're probably going to have a waxy coat. Now, if you don't know, you could just take your finger and scrape it along. And if white wax comes off, then you've got a waxy coat on it. That's not something you want to necessarily eat. And then I also advise you to buy them organic, right? Organic, they're going to have probably a higher content of the good bacteria on them. So if you do have a waxy coat, you're going to want to peel the cucumber and get that skin off. And if you don't have a waxy coat, then don't even wash them. We want them as, unless they're muddy. If you get like muddy ones, maybe wash those off a little. But we want to keep as much bacteria that is on these already and put it in our ferment. So it's very easy. You're going to take a knife. We're going to chop them in half and we're going to make these little swords. So I'll just show you here. So chop it in half and you're going to chop it in half again till you get these. Place it down and always be mindful of your fingers when you are using a big knife. And you're going to be making these little swords, soldiers, spears, whatever you want to call them. I find that these just, it's easier to manage their floating in the brine a little bit better than if you were to cut them round. So once you've cut up all your cucumbers, you're going to need to grab a jar. Now, I think this jar is bigger than my last jar. My last jar is a liter and a half. Ooh, it's really heavy. So this one's probably about 2 liters, which is what I want because I want more pickles. So I'm just going to plop them in. Now I'm going to try and stand them up a little bit and pack them in. Now if you want to do a smaller jar, maybe your first time around, that's totally fine. Just kind of, why don't you do, if you were to do a smaller one, do half of what I do. So you only need one cucumber, one medium-sized cucumber, and you'll want a half the water and half the salt that I use. So I've cut up one, I'm gonna cut up my cukes are in. The next thing I'm gonna wanna grab is some garlic. And some people, if you wanna just do them plain, go for it. I am obsessed with garlic. And if you've watched the other fermenting videos, you'll know that garlic is incredibly good for you and your immune system. And so it's one of those foods that I eat tons and tons of because I don't want to get sick. I don't want to do it. Don't want to deal with that. So you want to peel that little skin off the garlic. And if you don't get all of it, it totally doesn't matter. This one's got a little yucky part on it. So I'm just going to cut that off, get most of that skin off. All right. And then I'm just going to cut it up into little, not little tiny pieces, but maybe medium-sized pieces. So I'm going to do that for the rest of this garlic head. It's maybe 1, 2, 3, 5 cloves. You can always do more garlic or less garlic. And some people really like dill pickles. Now, I am not that person. I do not like the taste of dill, but you can put in whatever herbs and spices you want. If you want to make them really spicy, you could put in like a jalapeno pepper or something. So that is up to you. Your flavorings are up to you. I'm going to be putting in garlic and some peppercorns, some whole peppercorns. And it just adds a little bit of a kick. I think with this one, I might even add a little bit of cayenne, because why not, right? Next thing you're going to need is half of whatever size you've got. So if I've got 2 liters, I'm going to get a liter of warm water. Warm is going to help dissolve your salt better. So then I'm going to grab my tablespoon. Remember, tablespoon is the TBSP. That's the biggest one you've got. We're going to do four. I'm doing four of those for 2 liters. I'm going to put it in the warm water. One. Two. Didn't work. And if you recall, I'm using sea salt. It's important to not use iodized table salt, because that's actually just something we don't really want to be ingesting. It's a very processed salt. So sea salt is going to be your most natural salt. And I'm just going to use my knife here. I'm going to spin it around. All right, set that aside for a minute. I also brought over my... I am not like one of those fancy chefs on those shows that people watch. We have all that space. Just got a little kitchen here. All right, so I've got my peppercorns. I'm gonna put in maybe 2 or 3 times that amount. Oh. All right, just whole, they'll soak through. You can always grind it in if you want to. And then, I'm thinking about, I'm gonna put in a little bit of this cayenne, because I also really like things spicy. Okay. All right, next you're gonna add your water and salt. And if you recall, a lot of my salt didn't go in. If you recall, you want your, whatever you're fermenting needs to be underneath the brine. And the brine is the salty water mixture. Almost there. Because my water wasn't warm enough. All right, I'm just going to do a little quick stir here. Now, hopefully you'll just stir with a spoon, because this feels a little wild. But it's okay. So my cucumbers are not fully under the brine, which means I'm gonna go make some more brine. I just added a little bit more warm water to get the rest of the salt under here. There we go. And I always wanna leave what's called that headroom, which is this space on top. Okay, now here's the thing. Cucumbers float, so you're going to need something to weigh them down. You have options. If you find a good size rock and you really, really scrub it down, maybe even boil it for a while, you could use that as a weight. They also sell fancy sauerkraut weights, but I personally am like, we don't need that. So let me show you what I did with this one. So with this one, I did not have a sauerkraut weight, but I did have this tiny little mug. So I just filled that with water, salt, the salty water, so a little bit more brine just in case any spilled. And I sat it on top, and all the spears are underneath the brine. Now, I did mess with that a little bit. So for this one, it's got a little bit of a wider mouth. I think what I'm going to be doing is I just finished a wonderful jar of olives, and I'm going to reuse that jar. It's nice and wide, and it's going to fit perfectly in there and hold down all these little guys who are trying to peek up. And then I'm gonna take a piece of cloth, pop it over the top, and rubber band it. Now, cucumbers, because they're not super hard and tough and won't take too long to ferment, it's It's like a week long, maybe 2 week long ferment. It's a very quick one, as opposed to the fire cider, which I taught you about, which is a long ferment, a 6 week ferment, or the garlic ferment that I'll be teaching you about next, which is a 6 month ferment. So this one's nice, quick, and easy. And I mean, this one I put in, like I said, on 9/20, so September 20th, and it's the 20, I believe it's the 23rd today, and already delicious. So you really can't go wrong. I do want to repeat myself with one thing that I have talked about in the other videos, is if you see a white scum on top, totally fine. That's that Lactobacillus acidophilus. That is that good bacteria forming on the top. If your scum is a black or brown color, you're going to want to start over. Maybe it means that something in here was not clean enough. And while I do like to invite bacteria, I do make sure my vessels are clean before I put things into them. So another thing I really like to do, and this will be my last thought before we go, is, I don't know if you can see it, there's writing on here. I just take a Sharpie and write the date that I made it, and then just so that I can remember, I wrote 9/20/20, 1 to 2 weeks, so that when I come back, or when I look at it, I go, oh, when did I make that? And then, oh, I made that on 9/20. And then I can also look and say, oh, how many weeks is that ferment again? 1 to 2. All right, so you can put this on. If you've got the lid, which I don't have the lid, if you put the lid on, you're just gonna have to burp it every day. All right, enjoy. I'm so excited to hear about all your fermenting adventures.